Hello everybody, Teagan here. Thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's episode of What is in the Night Sky this month, October edition. Tonight I'm going to be taking you on a beautiful tour of the universe, and we're going to be visiting the planets, the moon, and several deep sky objects that you might find on a clear night in the month of October. So as always, let's buckle in and see what's really out there. First stop on our tour tonight, we're going to stay within our own solar system and see what the moon and the planets are up to this month. Mars is lost to the sun's glare this month. Saturn remains visible throughout the evening in Aquarius with a waxing gibbous moon nearby on the 23rd and the 24th. Neptune is moving through neighboring Pisces and is observable for a few hours after sunset until the early hours of morning. Next, over the horizon is Jupiter. Best seen in the hours shortly before or after midnight, the planet is nearing opposition in Aries and is visited by a waning gibbous moon in the morning and the hours of the second. Uranus is also in Aries and can be found 2 degrees southeast of Botene throughout the month. Venus, on the other hand, is an unmistakable sight in the pre-dawn twilight and rises nearly 4 hours before the sun. It spends the month in Leo and will be closest to Regulus on the 9th, when 2.3 degrees will separate the two. A waning crescent moon appears to their left the following morning. Early risers can also catch a quick glimpse of Mercury for the first week, shining at a bright magnitude negative 1.1, low over the eastern horizon, about 20 minutes before sunrise. The moon turns new on the 14th and brings a beautiful annular solar eclipse with it, and then turns full on the 28th. Now, we just mentioned something about an annular solar eclipse coming up on October the 14th. Let's talk a little more about this. The event for US observers in 2023 is the annular solar eclipse that cuts a path from the Pacific Northwest to the Gulf of Mexico. As an added bonus, a partial eclipse will be visible from every location in the contiguous United States. Totality will be visible from numerous towns and cities, but the city with the longest period of totality is Corpus Christi, Texas, with a duration of 5 minutes and 2.1 seconds. Texas locations will generally see a longer eclipse, while the best chances of good weather will be in Arizona and in New Mexico. And for those of you who would love to view totality of the annular eclipse live, but just can't get to the path of totality, make sure you subscribe to our channel because we will be hosting the event live. Kyle here with High Point will be filming and broadcasting the entire event live on October 14th, so you are not going to want to miss that. So for our next object tonight, we're going to travel far past the reaches of our solar system and take a look at a deep sky object called the Blue Snowball. NGC 7662, or the Blue Snowball, is a fine example of how planetary nebula got their name. A magnification of just under 100 times through a telescope will show a small, circular, slightly blue disk, much like a planet. Increasing the magnification to over 200 times will reveal its oval form in larger scopes, as well as rings of blue and green surrounding the darker center. If you want to spot the central star, you will need a telescope with a 400 millimeter aperture or larger. The larger your telescope when viewing planetary nebula, the better. It collects more light, and you get to see deeper, more rich colors and more detail within the nebula itself. Our next target is one of the oldest star clusters known, NGC 7789. Discovered in 1783 by Caroline Herschel, NGC 7789 is one of the oldest star clusters known. It is bright enough to be seen with binoculars and is within the same binocular field of view as CAF in Cassiopeia. Small telescopes show it as a rich and concentrated patch of faint stars with no discernible core, while mid-sized scopes show a band of stars encircling the center. So the next destination on this tour in the night of October is our first Messier object of the night, Messier 30. Messier 30 lies within the same binocular field of view as Zeta Capricorni, with M30 found just 3.25 degrees to the east. A telescope in a magnification of around 100 times will show the slightly elongated core, and there may be some resolution along the cluster's edge with averted vision. Chains of stars within Messier 30 can also be seen with larger telescopes. Messier 30 is a somewhat dim but beautiful globular cluster. The next and the last deep sky object on our tour tonight is another Messier object, Messier 52. Although visible with binoculars under dark skies, the best views of Messier 52 are through a telescope. At a low magnification of just 35 times, you'll easily see the orange star 4 Cassiopeia within the middle of the field of view. The cluster itself appears compact and conical, with a bright star at the tip and a base that's brighter than the rest of the cluster. If you have a smaller scope and want to see more stars, we recommend using averted vision. All right, so that is it for our tour tonight of the night sky in the month of October. Just as a reminder, if you want to experience with us the annular eclipse, tune in on October 14th around noon Eastern, and this is when the event will start. We're going to be live during the entire eclipse, and you will not want to miss it. We have provided a link in the description to that live stream, so make sure you click on it and set a reminder. If you have any questions, let us know in the comments below, and we will be more than happy to assist. Thank you so much, and clear skies.